Yep. And a car. to the 1993 Glencoe High School graduation. I would like to read from the book After the Tassels Moved by Lewis O. Caldwell. Now that we have made it, we are in the company of thousands of others who stand with diplomas in our hands, asking the question, where to now? There is a time for everything and a season for every activity under heaven, Ecclesiastes 3:1. Now at graduation is this time and season for deciding which direction our lives will take us and how we will prepare for what looms ahead. Consider these two suggestions. Know where the rocks are and prepare for life's inevitable experiences. Matthew 7:24-29 says, therefore, everyone who hears these words of mine and puts them into practice is like a wise man who built his house on the rock. The rain came down, the streams rose, the winds blew and beat against that house, yet it did not fall, because it had its foundations on the rock. But everyone who hears these words of mine and does not put them into practice is like a foolish man who built his house on the sand. The rain came down, the streams rose, the wind blew and beat against that house, and it fell with a great crash. In 5, 10, or 25 years, where will you be? Looking ahead to the future, you can plan with the greatest confidence if you trust in the Lord with your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge Him, and He shall direct your path. Proverbs 3, 5, and 6. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for this day, and thank you for the many memories we share. Thank you for our parents and educators who have taught us well. Please keep us safe as we go our separate ways and as we begin college and careers. Help us to always remember you are there for us no matter what. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Parents, friends, faculty, and fellow classmates, we have reached a milestone in our lives. Graduation is something we've looked forward to for years and we have finally made it. First, I would like to thank the parents and friends for their understanding and support during the high school years, a difficult time of growing and maturing in attitude toward life and outlook concerning the future. We appreciate your love and guidance, and the lessons you have taught us will lead us through the rest of our lives. Next, thanks to the faculty for helping us achieve our academic goals and for showing a genuine interest in each individual student. Also, thank you for teaching us how to think for ourselves and how to express our opinions. Finally, my fellow students, 12 long years ago, each one of us started out in first grade as one kid trying to make it out there in the scary world of elementary school. Over the years, every one of us has made friends and got interested in different things, whether it was sports, cheerleading, music, or anything else. We were always around people with common interests. Yet, it still seemed like it was every person for himself or herself. Once we entered high school, however, everything changed. Somewhere, during all the classes, all the parties, all the dances, all the sporting events, we became much close friends. We became closer friends. We have been together to celebrate the good times and to help each other make it through the bad times. The tragic loss of a classmate brought us all together in mutual sadness and support. We have waited 12 years for this day. In these past 12 years, we have all grown up and matured, not just individually, but we have also grown together as a group of close friends who will, from this day forward, be known as Glencoe's class of 1993. Thank you.
Mr. Smith, faculty, parents, platform guests, friends, and fellow graduates, today is a day that we have planned for and looked forward to for many years. It is a time that we look back on our failures and successes and wonder about the disappointments and accomplishments that face us in our future. As the graduating class of 1993, we have become as one mind. We have worked together, we have labored for knowledge, we have opened our minds to new ideas. We have done all of this and we have succeeded. We have come through. Yet even as we realize this, we know that today is not an ending, but a transition from one phase of our lives to another. Each phase or step leads to new and different pathways. While there is love and fondness for what we have done, there is joy for what is yet to come. This very special time in our life is only possible through the grace of God and the help of dedicated parents and teachers. To each of you, we say thank you. We ask that you continue to support and encourage us in the many challenges we're about to face. To you, my fellow graduates, I hope this day will be the start of productive and satisfying lives. Let us always use the knowledge we have gleaned in our school for the betterment of our lives and those of our fellow human beings. May the days that we have spent at Glencoe High School be but the beginning of happy and fulfilling days to come. In closing, I would like to leave you with this poem by Bruce Wilmer entitled New Beginnings. Each chapter that is ending leads us to a new beginning. The past that we are leaving means a future we are winning. Each change that fills the present sets the stage for our tomorrow, and how we meet each challenge helps determine joy or sorrow. In every new beginning, spirit plays a vital part. We must approach tomorrow with a strong and steady heart. So as we turn the corner, let's all apprehension shed and fill our hearts with confidence as we proceed ahead.
Recognize some scholarship winners. They're listed in our program. If you'd like to follow along with me, I'm going to read them. These folks deserve recognition. Some people have several, so I'm going to read through them and congratulate them. There are several still pending. Maybe there will be several more given. Todd Cook got a 2-year full tuition scholarship to Gadsden State. He got a faculty scholarship to Jacksonville State. He got a Temple Henlon Award for $1,000 cash. And he got the Malcolm Edge Award for $500 cash. Matthew Whiteley got the Temple Henlon Award, $1,000 cash. Lee Blevins got a 2-year full tuition scholarship to Gadsden State. Misty Pig, 2-year half tuition, and also a $700 scholarship to Gadsden State. Christy Pig, 2-year tuition to Gadsden State. Ashley Cothran, 2-year athletic and tuition to Gadsden State, plus the $500 Haney Cash Award. Dana Langford, 2-year tuition to Jeff State. Kerry Hornbuckle, 2-year athletic and tuition to Gadsden State. Kevin Crowder, 2-year athletic and tuition to Gadsden State. This special occasion, Glencoe High School honored the 1993 graduating class of Glencoe High School. First, I would like to, do we have the mayor of Glencoe or any city officials with us? If we do, please stand. Okay, we have our superintendent of education, Dr. Ralph Kane. Dr. Kane, glad to have you with us. In you people's lives, Glencoe High School faculty and staff. If you're on the faculty or staff at Glencoe High School, please stand now. These folks have been very instrumental in a lot of your lives. Special thanks to Mr. Alton Yancey, Mr. Wayne Finley, Mr. Pat Davis, Ms. Debbie Handy, and Ms. Mary Ann Clayton, whose daughter is graduating from Emma this afternoon, couldn't be with us, but they're your senior sponsors and our assistant principal, and appreciate them very much. Now, if you're a parent of a graduate, all parents of graduates, please stand very fast for you to meet. Set you some goals, make preparations for the future. Make sure and prepare yourself mentally, physically, and spiritually. If you'll make these preparations, you'll be prepared to overcome any obstacle you may face. Life is like a big tall ladder. You've already climbed 13 rungs. Kindergarten through the 12th grade, you've climbed 13 rungs. But I hope and pray that many of you will climb many, many, many more rungs. Keep education one of your priorities. You've got to have it. We love you very much, and good luck to you. Also, we have a special award today. On March 2nd, 1991, one of our students, one of your fellow classmates, and one of your closest friends was taken away from us, Karen Thompson. I know her memory has loomed very large with you, because I've watched you play, you girls especially, play basketball and softball, and you've worn green ribbons, and I know her memory has stayed with you. In her memory, we're presenting a diploma to her mom, dad, and Kevin. Also, the flowers in front of the podium. When the graduation is over today, we'd like for them to take them with them. If one of y'all come, please let me present you a diploma in her name.
Carrie Joanna Hornbuckle. Sue Haynes Abel. Chad Lang Amos. Lee Ann Blevins. Rachel Lane Brown. Wendy Michelle Cheatwood. Elizabeth Cochran. Kevin Lee Crowder. Wendy Michelle Daugherty. Joy Lamar Dodd. Jennifer Michelle Dunaway. Christy Lynn Fant. Michael Kim Ford. Susan Renee Galloway. Stacy Lynn Green. Lee Brandon Gregory. Randa Janine Harris. Gregory Scott Hathcock. Brian Eugene Hill. Linda Ann Hope. Mary Catherine Jacobs. Dana Brooke Langer. April Michelle Linton. William Jason Lockmiller. Travis Joseph Marquardt. Jason Heath Meacham.
Thank you. stand here a minute, yeah.
Yes, I see him. He's hugging another girl.
Oh, we may never get there.
Hallelujah.
Looking back on the memory of the dance we shared beneath the stars above. For a moment, all the world was right. How could I have known that you'd ever say goodbye? And then I'm glad I didn't know the way it all would end, the way it all would go. Our lives are better left to change. I could have missed the pain, but I'd have had to miss the day. But if I'd only know how to keep
listed in the maps of Tierra Incognita, see?
Yes, Father. Particularly the area of the Grand Pajonal.
There's been a lot of interest in the Grand Pajonal recently. Do you know why?
No, I don't.
About 3 weeks ago, someone broke in.
I've done, but now I'm running the water. Since I have a doubt without you, yeah. And I'll thank you.
just a drop of water in the sea. All we do crumbles to the ground, though we refuse to see.
Right now, I'm just in so much pain.